Good, how are you?
It was all right.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening and welcome to the Power Aid Centre, Brampton, Ontario, for this evening's Bill of Boxing. The boys are back in town, brought to you by Lee Baxter Promotions, Ontario. Make some noise! Ladies and gentlemen, this evening's Bill of Boxing is sponsored by Dos Equis, Stay Thursday, Everlast, the choice of champions, Hard Knocks Gym, Toronto's newest downtown training facility, Time Reversal Tattoo, Ontario's number one laser tattoo removal, and Monte Carlo Inn, your home away from home. Ladies and gentlemen, we're now streaming right around the world on the World Wide Web via LeeBaxterPromotions.com, and time now for our first event of the evening. This one scheduled for 4 3-minute rounds of boxing, this in the super bantamweight division. Firstly, to make his ring walk to the blue corner, please welcome from Zamora, Mexico, Emmanuel Villamar. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to make his way to the red corner, boxing out of London, Ontario, Brampton, please welcome Mark Pagkaliwanga. Also to boxing fans ringside at the Powerade Centre, Brampton, Ontario. Time now for bout number one of our evening. This bout sanctioned by the Ontario Athletics Commission. The commissioner in charge at ringside is Ray Dempster. This is a super bantamweight contest. We are scheduled for 4 3-minute rounds of boxing. Should the bout go the distance, it will be scored by our three judges at ringside. Alan Davis, Pasquale Procopio, and Harry Davis. Our timekeepers on the bell at ringside are Bill Mackey and Dave Morden, and the third man in the ring is our referee in charge of this bout, introducing Rocky Zolnicek. Here we go then, ladies and gentlemen, with bout number one of our night. Firstly, introducing in the blue corner, his official weight for the contest, 123.2 pounds. Tonight, he's wearing the grey shorts trimmed with green and has a fight record including 8 victories with just 1 defeat on his record. Boxing out of Zamora, Mexico, introducing Emmanuel Villamar. across the ring, boxing out of the red corner stands his opponent. His weight for the contest, 123.6 pounds. Wearing the red shorts tonight, and bringing a fight record to the ring of 10 visits, 9 victories, with 1 draw on his record. Boxing out of London, Ontario. Brampton, please welcome. Welcome the undefeated Mark Pakaiwenga! Referee Rocky Zolacek will now issue his final instructions.
Okay, fighters, you've received my instructions in the change room. I expect you to obey my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Touch up.
Bout number one of our evening, ladies and gentlemen. This one's scheduled for 4 3-minute rounds of boxing in the super bantamweight division.
Well, yeah, it probably affects
And round one begins. Our opening contest here at the Powerade Center in Brampton. Four rounds in the super bantamweight division. Mark Pakaiwenga in the red trunks. His opponent, Emmanuel Villamar of Mexico, in the silver trimmed with green. And a good shot.
Thank you.
Check, check, check. 1-2. Check, 1-2. Check, check, check. I can't hear myself, but I don't know if I'm coming through. Check. Over here. Check, check. Check, check, check. It's maxed. Here. Check, 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 check. Check.
Hi, is Dana available? It's Matt from Boston. Hey, Dana. I was just wondering. Probably like under her seat in her car or something.
By Emmanuel Villamar. Might have been a balance issue there, Eric, but definitely the best shot of the fight for Villamar thus far on Pakalewanga.
Villamar seems to be getting some confidence after that rough first round, and Mark's letting him back into the fight, which could prove to make for a tough third and fourth round if he keeps letting him come back like that.
Pakalewanga looks for the uppercut.
Right there. 5-2.
Certainly using a lot more movement here in the third round than in the opening two frames. And a lot of that could be due to the confidence that Villamar is gaining and the fact that he feels like he can press forward. He's tasted Pakalewanga's power. He's still there. And now he's giving himself opportunities to win this fight.
Well, Villamar has proven to be tough. I think he got caught cold a little bit in the first round, but he's proven to be tough here in Canada before losing a very good decision against Francois Pratt, who's a Canadian prospect out of Quebec. So I did expect him to get up and keep pressing forward and making this a fight. And down
big
he goes again.
Left hook from Pat Galiwangan, and that could erase everything. Villamar up early. But we'll see how much that's impacted him. Another left hook drops him. Rocky Zolnarczyk up to five. Bakaliwanga races across the ring. He has an opportunity here. Villamar shaking, and that will be it. Mark Bakaliwanga, just like that, when we thought maybe Villamar was finding his way back into this fight, one left hook changed everything.
That's two thundering left hooks that started that caused both knockdowns, while the first and the second, which was the beginning of the end in the second one, which was a good time to go for the stoppage. I was happy to see Mark go in for the kill. He got rid of a lot of ring rust there after a two-year layoff. He got a few rounds in and scores a big win, which is exactly what I'm sure what he was looking for.
Yeah, in a lot of ways, it's exactly what you would want for a guy coming off a two-year layoff. He's been a lot of time in the gym. We'll take a look at how this fight ended in just a moment. But as you said, you get a couple rounds in. You did have to weather a bit of a storm, but then you show you still have that knockout power as which that left hook lands.
Which is ideal after a couple years of inactivity. You want to be reminded what a fight is like. You don't want to go in there and have a sparring session. He's been in the gym. He has been training. I think a lot of that, you saw a lot of it in the ring tonight. And that's what you want. You want someone that's going to come and remind you that, hey, this is a fight. This isn't the gym, to get you back into the swing of things and get rid of that rust. And that's exactly what he got tonight out of
Well, and as you and I were talking about offline, for a fighter like Pat Galiwangan, who fights at 122 pounds, and we've seen him at 118 in the past, including his win over Richard Voros in Montreal, which we were ringside for, in terms of sparring, you know, if you're a Canadian super bantamweight, it's kind of tough for you to find good sparring. However, if you're in California, Eric, it's a litany of great fighters in and around that weight class. They can bring guys in from Mexico. There's lots of talent for you to get in the ring with, and I think we saw that here with Pat Galiwangan here tonight. Clearly, he's been pushed by better fighters.
Absolutely. He's come a long way. Although he stopped Richard Voros in the first round back in Quebec, he definitely looked a lot more calm, a lot
Ladies
more settled, a lot more professional here than
the
against Richard
Voros. The sport of boxing is all about respect.
All right, let's send it up to our ring announcer, Paul Booth, for the official decision.
Sure everybody would like to put their hands together as a show of appreciation for their efforts. The official end of the contest is recorded at 2 minutes 49 seconds of round number 3. Referee Rocky Zolnarczyk stops the contest. Villamar in no position to continue. Therefore, your winner and still undefeated from London, Ontario, Mark Pacquiao. Emmanuel Villamar.
So your winner, Mark Pacquiao-Galiwangan. An impressive performance from Mark, as we mentioned, 2 years spent training in California in two of the best gyms in all of boxing, Robert Garcia's Boxing Academy in Oxnard, California. And of course, at the Wildcard Gym with Freddie Roach, spending some time sparring there as well. Clearly, it paid off for Pacquiao-Galiwangan, and I'm sure he's hoping to be a lot busier than he has been in recent years.
Yeah, I'm sure with a performance like that, the crowd seems to be behind him, seems to have come out to support him. I'm sure it won't be very long. It definitely shouldn't be 2 years before we see him right back here at home in Ontario.
Upstairs, where we are showing the pay-per-view showing